Hey guys, welcome back to my Second Life channel. Today I've got another Black Dragon photography tutorial for you, which is the second in my series looking at the daddy of Second Life viewers for graphics and machinima. My first Black Dragon video was an overview of some of the best features, including posing, depth of field, and camera shortcuts. Today we're diving even deeper into the poser, and I'm also going to be providing even more tips, tricks, and shortcuts to enhance your photography skills. This video is perfect for beginners to Black Dragon, but the experienced masters also can sit back and enjoy the fun and hopefully learn a few new hacks. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to my channel and be the first to be notified of my Second Life tutorials, events, free gifts, and monthly 10,000 Linden giveaways. And I always love to hear from you, so comment below and share one of your favorite tips for the Black Dragon viewer. But let's get straight into the photo shoot. I've set up my scene here by using a backdrop from Nebula Cyborg for this really cool cyberbar vibe. For the initial starting pose, we're going to use an animation from my inventory from a store called Wrong. With Second Life poses, the majority of them will need some form of modification on your body, since we all come in different shapes and sizes. But Black Dragon allows you to make all of those modifications for free within the viewer, so we don't need to purchase an additional HUD. To open up the poser, click the body icon. If it's not already in your toolbar, you can add it for quick use by right-clicking the toolbar, then select toolbar buttons and drag and drop the icon that you need. And we now need to just select our name from the list on the left-hand side, so I'm clicking Boston Blaisdell, and then hit Start Posing. And this will reset your skeleton and the poser is now in control of your body. We've got three main tabs in the poser. We've got rotation, position, and scale. And we're going to look at all of these during the video. Most importantly, we have a long list of every limb that we can manipulate. And to begin, I'm going to reposition my avatar so that I'm sitting on top of the bar. To do this, I'm selecting the position tab and then targeting the M pelvis object, which is near the top of the list. And by selecting this, I can now control the X, Y, and Z axis. And you can move your avatar pretty much anywhere you like. I'm using my mouse to get the approximate position, but I'm then going to single click the slider and use the arrow buttons on my keyboard to make smaller incremental changes. And you can see this is reflected in the axis numbers on the right hand side. If I was to make a mistake and need to go back to my last position, a great tip is to simply right click the slider and it will revert back to the last position. And you can use the right click function for any of the sliders in the viewer. Now that we have our position set, we're going to jump over to the rotation tab and start moving our limbs. So sticking with the M pelvis object, I'm just making some minor adjustments to the tilt of my full avatar, whilst keeping it fixed in a stationary position. Now if I wanted to move my arm down, I would target the right elbow and play with the position of that. But I'm actually going to keep this connected to the left arm so that the fingers are touching. For the left leg, I'm targeting the left hip object and just moving it slightly so that the left arm is leaning more into it. And then we're going to make some adjustments to the position of the head. The axis sliders allow you to move the neck into any position so that you can either have it looking directly into the camera or off shot into the distance. Sometimes with poses, I find that the body parts can look a little small and crushed into the body. And Black Dragon is amazing as we can use the scale tab to resize the limb. Here what I'm doing is targeting the M collar right objects for the right arm. And you can see as I'm moving the axis sliders, it's resizing and giving more proportion and position to the arm, shoulder and back. So this is really good if you have a great pose but the body looks too small or too large in certain areas. Rather than editing the shape of your body, you can just play with the scale of the limbs in the poser. The other adjustments I'm making here are to the mouth. I'm targeting the face, lip, upper left and upper right objects, which are under the head category. And just moving the sliders so that I have less of a moody frown and more of a slight smile. And there's lots of adjustments that you can make with the different parts of the lips, so I definitely recommend experimenting with this. Just one thing to remember here guys is that all of the adjustments that you make in the poser are only reflected locally, meaning that you're the only person who sees this. All other avatars will only see you in your original starting pose animation and won't see any of the movements or adjustments. Now you'll want to save this pose and that's super simple. Just type the name of the pose and click the save button, which is this arrow icon. And when you open up the right hand menu, it will show all of the poses that you've saved. So I can click on one that I made earlier, which toggles immediately to that pose and position. This one where I'm just chilling on the floor. And then I can just click the previous pose and I'm immediately back to my save position. Now for this wind light, I'm using one of the system presets named Verdigris, and I've accessed that just by clicking the Sky Editor button. To scan through EEP wind lights quickly, just choose one from the drop-down menu, and then hold your shift and arrow keys to go up or down. And this is a much quicker way of finding the wind light of your choice. Once you have your preferred wind light, just use the north and east sliders to reposition the sun and cast shadows on your subject and scene. And of course, this makes a huge difference to the quality of your photo. And again, I can just use the arrow keys to make incremental changes rather than using my mouse. Now I'm going to find my camera position, and then I'm going to hit Shift and E to roll my camera right, or Shift and Q to roll the camera left. And this is actually one of my favorite camera settings in Black Dragon, and allows you to roll your camera a full 360 degrees if you needed to. As covered in my previous video, F1 opens up the machinima bar, and that's where we can access lots of visual settings and preferences. And I'm just adding a slight vignette to this shot. And then the shortcut for taking a snapshot is Control, Shift, and S. Just increase the resolution to a pixel size that your computer will allow, and then save your picture either to your computer or directly to your inventory. And that's it for this quick tutorial on the Black Dragon Poser and other shortcuts for your Second Life photos. If that was useful, guys, please give this video a thumbs up and look out for my other tutorials on the Black Dragon series. I'll link the playlist in the description below. Thanks for watching, take care, guys, and see you soon.